Almighty God, I bless your name. Holy One, I will worship you, for you are God all by yourself. For you are God all by yourself. Eight to eight, you're still the same. Our creation will shout for joy, for you are the God all by yourself.
Oh God.
For you are God all by yourself. God by yourself.
Oh God, oh God.
For you are God by yourself.
Oh God, oh God.
For you are God by yourself. Oh God, oh God. Praise your name. For who you are, I worship you. For you are God by yourself. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I worship you, Father. I glorify your mighty name, Lord Jesus. I exalt your mighty name, Abba Father. I lift up my hands and adore you, God, and adore you, Jesus. And I worship you, Father, and I glorify your mighty name. Lord, your God, by yourself, you are sovereign, Lord. You are sovereign, Lord. You are the creator. You are the mighty one. You are the glorious God and the wonderful God. Lord God, angels of army, we worship you. We adore your name. We adore your name, mighty God. We bow before your throne. We put our crowns to adore you, Jesus. There is no God like you. You alone, you stand to be God by yourself. You are God by yourself, and we adore you, Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus Christ, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I call your name right now. I call your name in this evening. I call your name this hour, dear Lord. Sanctify me, Lord. Sanctify me, God. And sanctify every person that shall watch me. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. And I cover every person that shall watch me with the blood of Jesus Christ. We adore you, Jesus. We adore you, Jesus. We adore you, Jesus. There is none like you, Father. Ribakoza tolabako sheke yanto leboka. Rikozantala makozeke yanto leboka. Rikantala makoza toleko shantala boka zeteleka. Rika yantala makozanta makozeteleko shantara boko. Akozeke yente ribrika bazote. Makozako yanto leko shantala baka. Rikantala makozeteleka yanta. Makozeba yente reba. Rikanzantala kozaka yanta. Yantalaba, Riko zetele mako kazotelebo, Rakantala mako zeteleba, Rika yantala mako bazote leko yente, Brika bazote, Brika yantoleboka, Mako zeteleko shanta, Rika zontala kosheba yente. Thank you, Lord Jesus God. Thank you, Jesus. You are my Lord and you are my Savior. It's you I'm talking about this hour, Lord. It's you I'm speaking about you, oh God. God of angels, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. We adore you, Jesus. We adore you, Father. We adore you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. There is none like you, Father. There is none like you, Father. There is none like you, Jesus. Oh, Rabako seke yanto reboka. Riko zanto lama kozo koyeke yente leko zatalaba. Rako zema yente reka yanta laboka. Rika mazota lako shente leba. Rakanta labaka zaka yanta raboka. Mako zete leba. Rikanta lama zete leboka. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Receive all glory and honor. Receive all adoration, Father. Let this place be sanctified. Let this telecast be sanctified. I speak your word. The Revelation 12:11. We overcame Satan with the blood of the Lamb, but the testimony is in our mouth. We overcame every challenge of the enemy. We overcome every spirit of sickness and disease. We overcome every spirit of fear. We overcome every spirit of stagnancy and every spirit of failure and every spirit of destruction. We overcame all of them with the blood of Jesus Christ. And we stand on the word of God that says, Hebrews 4:16, we come boldly to the throne of grace so that we may receive mercy and obtain grace. Oh Lord, I come to receive mercy from your throne. Oh Lord, I come to obtain mercy and obtain grace from your throne, oh Lord Jesus Christ. And you gave us power and authority to tread upon serpent, upon scorpion, and upon powers of the enemy, and nothing by enemy shall harm us in Jesus' mighty name. That's what you say in the book of Luke 10:19. And let everything that has been attacking our life, let everything that has been attacking our finances, let everything that has been attacking our families, our children, let everything that has been attacking our health, let everything that has been attacking our income, let everything that has been attacking our society, let it be rebuked at the mention of your name, Jesus Christ. Let it be rebuked in your name, Jesus Christ. We declare there is power in your name, Lord. For God exalted the name of Jesus above everything in heaven, on earth, and at the earth. And at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee bows down and every tongue confesses that Jesus Christ is Lord. Even the kidnapping that is going on, we rebuke it in Jesus' mighty name. Every crisis happening in our country and in the world, we rebuke it at the mention of your name, Jesus. Oh Lord, receive all glory and honor, Father. May you use me as your vessel, Father. May you use me as your vessel, Jesus Christ. Abba, Father, touch your children, Father. As I speak your word, Father, as use me as your tool, as your vessel, to just speak what you're going to put in me, Father. As I speak the word of restoration, let the words come from you, Lord. I decree so that you may increase, Father, and that you may speak and minister unto us. Your word never returns to you void, never returns to you empty, but it fulfills which that you've sent it to do, Father. As we speak your word in this place, Father, let your word come and accomplish which that you've sent to do unto us this hour, Lord. Minister unto our health, minister to our children, minister to our families, minister to the youth, to the women, to the men, any person who shall watch me, even those who are at home, Father, even those who are in school or there in their vehicles, Father, minister unto us, Almighty God. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. You said, where two or three are gathered, you are in their midst. Distance is not a barrier. It doesn't matter where they are watching me from. Lord, it is your spirit that will touch them. It is your anointing and your power that will touch them. And as we are in an agreement with the word restoration, there shall be restoration in their lives. There shall be a turnaround. There shall be an overflow. There shall be a reconstruction and rebuilding in their lives, or whatever the enemy has stolen or killed or destroyed in their lives. There shall be a restoration, because we serve a God who is a life. God is listening. God is merciful. God is kind. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said, your hand is not short that it cannot deliver us, nor your ear too dull that it cannot hear our prayers, but our iniquities or our sins have separated us from your face. Anything that is separating me from your face, anything that is separating us from your face, Lord, we cry for your mercy and forgiveness. Forgive us, Father. Forgive us, Jehovah. Forgive us, Abba, Father. Forgive us, Abba, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I know your face, you've already turned to us, for your mercies are new every morning. And whenever we pray, God, you're merciful to hear our prayers. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. There is none like you, Father. I believe, and I believe in my heart, it's a day of restoration. It's a day of restoration. And you're going to touch child of God somewhere. Their health shall be restored. Their families shall be restored. Their businesses shall be restored. Their careers, their ministry, their anointing, whatever the enemy had tempered with, shall be restored in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive all glory and adoration, Father. Let your blood wipe out anything that would hinder our prayers. Let it clear in the atmosphere. Let it clear the atmosphere. Any powers of darkness, any demon, any principality, anything that risen against the word of God or the wisdom of God, let blood of Jesus Christ clear it and silence it permanently in Jesus' name. We shut the gates of hell. We rebuke the demons of the waters. We rebuke the demons of the air. We rebuke the demons of the dry ground and the forest and the mountains. We silence them with the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way, Holy Spirit. Have your way, Spirit of the living God. Have your way, Jesus. Have your way, Holy Spirit. Touch us, Father. And I know whoever Jesus you touched, there was a testimony. There was a miracle. There was a visible thing in their life that happened to them. Lord Jesus Christ, touch us as we touch your name, as we mention your word. Any sickness is scattering. Any forces of darkness is scattering. As we mention your name, Father, we decree and declare, things shall never be the same again. Things shall never be the same again. Things shall never be the same again. As your anointing flows, as your power flows, as you're in our midst, there is a turnaround in every situation. There is a turnaround in every situation. Let your anointing declare this place holy ground, Father. Let your blood declare this place holy ground. Let every witchcraft or forces of darkness or altars that are erased in this area, let the blood of Jesus silence them as we speak your word. For your presence is here, Father. Your presence is here, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Raboko Sheke Yanto Leboka. I welcome all of you children of Most High God, sisters and brothers. I am coming to speak to you about restoration. And there is a restoration because Jesus said in John 10:10, the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But our faith is going to tell us tonight there is a restoration. We've all experienced the stealing, the killing, and the destruction in one way or the other. It could be in your health. Wherever you're sick, the enemy has tampered with your health, has tampered with your system. Whenever your business or your job is not working well, the enemy has tampered with your system of life. Not according to the will of God. It's not the will of God for his children to suffer. And if he allows it, there's a reason. But he also says, the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And he says this. Look at this tense. The enemy comes, but Jesus came once. He came so that you can have life and have it in abundance, and he's not gonna come again. He said all what you needed, it is already given to you freely. It is already given to you freely. God says, if I did not withhold my only son, how can I withhold anything good from you? Therefore, there is abundance and there is an overflow from the stores of course of God. And it's for his children to enjoy. The word restoration means returning something to the original owner or the place or something that needs to be restored to a certain place. I don't know what is that you've lost, child of God, but you cannot deny you've lost something. You, especially in these times where there's a pandemic, there's crisis in the economy. So many people have been laid off, but there's a God who turns around every situation. There's a God who does not walk with seasons. Seasons belongs to him. Times belongs to him. Fire and water belongs to him. He says in Isaiah 43 verses 1 to 2, even if you walk through the waters, the floods will not sweep you, the rivers will not destroy you. Whether you walk through the fire will not set you ablaze. Those are the biggest elements that the enemy knows can kill someone. Because fire and water can sweep a whole society or a whole country. But he says, even those two which the enemy thinks they are the strongest,
They cannot destroy you. Whenever you are a child of God, whenever you're connected to Him, whenever you know how to call Him, there is something called restoration, a path of returning whatever the enemy has stolen or had killed or destroyed in your life. And I declare, under the unction of the Holy Spirit, there is a restoration in your health. There is a restoration in your family. There is a restoration for that business. There is a restoration in that career. There is a restoration in your joy and in your peace, by the power in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power in the name of Jesus Christ, sir. And I can feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit in this place, powerful and strong. I don't know, and I want you to help me in this preaching. Child of God, I am just using a gadget to connect with you. I am not even where you are, but there's a woman watching me, and I want you to say, if that is you, just say, that is me. There is a pain on the lower abdomen on the left side. I come as a servant of God and as a prophet of God and declare total and instant healing to you. If that is you, just say, God, thank you, Jesus. Just say, thank you, Jesus, because you've been healed. Oh, bakacha taraboko zeke. Whoever you, it's a lady. Pain on the left side of the lower abdomen. Be healed in Jesus' name. We haven't even gotten halfway. Actually, I'm just beginning. And the anointing is too much. Just touch yourself with your right hand and say, thank you, Jesus. And you are completely healed. Someone watching me, pain on the left shoulder. Be healed in Jesus' mighty name. And under that same authority and the same anointing, I am coming to declare there's a turnaround, there's a lifting up, and there's a restoration in your life. If you believe, say amen. If you believe there's an anointing of restoration, say amen. Say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Maka shota laboko seke yantaraba. Rima kozete leboka yantaraboka seke yanta. So restoration is an act of returning something to the person, original person. Or it's also fixing. It is also reconstruction. It's rebuilding. It is giving a facelift of something to become new or better than how it was before. And there is a restoration in this place. There is a restoration, not in me. The grace is always for the people whom it has been sent to. And I can only pray, God, may you locate me as you locate your children. But the anointing is for someone who is watching me. Thank you, Jesus. That was Christine Mothui. I know God has touched you. I know God has touched you. And you are healed. That pain is gone and gone forever. And I come to announce under this anointing, I hear restoration for finances. I hear restoration for finances. I hear restoration for two things, finances and family. Not my words. I hear financial increase in the name of Jesus Christ. Two things, financial for two things. Ah, my goodness, they become three. As God releases them, we take them. Health, finances, and family. Health, finances, and family. In Jesus' mighty name. So God is going to fix that situation. God is going to recondition it. God is going to rebuild it and reconstruct it. And give it a new face. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. So, we say the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus came once to give you life and give it in abundance. Where there was any punching, distraction, failure, stealing, something not working well, Jesus is saying, I am coming to give you life this hour. I'm coming to give you life in Jesus' mighty name. I'm coming to give you life in Jesus' mighty name. I don't know which is that the enemy had destroyed in your life. Just say, Lord, locate me. Not Wanzilla. My name is Wanzilla, but not Wanzilla. Jesus, locate me. And let's see, there will not be a turnaround in Jesus' mighty name. There will be a turnaround in that ministry. There will be turnaround in that anointing. There will be turnaround in that family. There will be turnaround in that finances. So many jobs shall be released. Mako shataraboko zeke yantalaba. Riko zaka yantaraba. This is what God says in the book of Joel 2:25. I will repay you. Ari makozete. I will repay. Nitakulipa. I will repay you. You are my child. The time the enemy wasted for you when you are admitted in hospital, the time you were in the wilderness, the time you suffered shame, the time you suffered humiliation, I, the Lord, your God, of your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I will repay you the time. Whatever God is going to do in your life, it shall be so much such that you will forget the time you were in the wilderness and you were in a pain. I am looking at a situation where Joseph, yes, he had a dream. Yes, the brother hated him. Yes, and God had told him, I will exalt you more than your brothers. But he found himself in a pit. He found himself in a prison. He found himself being accused of things that he didn't understand. He found himself in a foreign country where there is no hope of him ever seeing his family again. But the moment God came and said, I am coming to repay you the time and to restore you, there was a total turnaround, such that in one day he forgot all the pain he has ever endured, ever encountered, such that when he saw his brother, there was even no time to revenge or even to tell them anything. This is what the Lord is saying. I will repay you the time. It doesn't matter how long the enemy, the situation has been. It doesn't matter how bad the situation might look. But when Jehovah speaks, Makasha Taraboka, when Jehovah speaks and says, I am coming to restore you and repay the time. This is what he says. I will repay you for the years, the time the locusts have eaten, the great locusts and the young locusts and the other locusts that I sent among you. You will eat in plenty until you're full, and you will praise the name of the Lord your God, who has what? Let me see. Who has worked wonders for you? And my people will never be ashamed again. No more shame. When God comes with a hand of restoration, he wipes away shame. He wipes away pain. He wipes away which that had made you to feel inferior, which that people had seen and said, God has forgotten you. He makes sure he has reconstructed your life, build it, give it a new facelift, raise you up until you say, when others are saying there's a casting down in my God, I say there's a lifting up. It came to a point where Joseph said, for sure there's a lifting up for those who wait on the Lord. I come to tell you, child of God who is watching me, I come to tell you, child of God who is connected to me, there is a season of restoration in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a season, and I hear financial increase in Jesus' mighty name. Makoshete leboka. Kitambaa yangu sijaribu kuanguka tafadhali. Kaa hapo tu. Maka satalaba. I come to stand as a prophet and declare a season of restoration. I am looking at 2 Kings chapter 5. Mashatara chapter 6. There's a man who had borrowed a neck's head, but it went and fell down. And then the good thing is that he was in the company of the servant of God, Prophet Elisha. And Prophet Elisha asked him, where did it fall? And he told him, it doesn't matter whatever the prophet will touch. He said, it's okay, what is near? It is a stick. Just threw in the River Jordan. And the XL, a metal, it swam back to the owner. I come to speak as a servant of God. May which that you lost, may it swim back to you in Jesus' mighty name. May it swim back to you. If it is your wealth, if it is your health, if it is your family, if it is your career, if it is your job, may it swim back to you in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Abba, Father, may this word be followed by signs and wonders. May you confirm it with your power. May you confirm it with your anointing. Rama kozako yanta, rabo sheke yanta. To any person who shall believe, Mantaraboko sheke yanta. Let there be total restoration. Let there be total restoration. And I can tell you there is a total restoration. Any person who had pain watching me, the pain disappeared instantly. And if I be a liar, please shame me here. Write on Facebook. Tell me I'm still having the pain. Any person with a pain. And I'm looking at someone. Marco Sakayanta, Mary Modiani, there's tears in your life. May God restore you which that is making you to cry. And may you never cry again in Jesus' mighty name. May you never cry again in Jesus' mighty name. And I'm looking also in 2 Kings, Makayanta, chapter 4, verses 1 to 7. I may not read it because it's a story we know all. We all know it. It's about the woman with empty jars. I don't know who is that with some emptiness. I don't know what is that. The enemy has made it to become empty. But God is about to fill it now. God is about to fill those empty jars in the name of Jesus Christ. This woman, her husband feared the Lord. He was always in the company of prophets, but he suffered sickness to an extent he died. And he left so many debts, such that the creditors came to take the two sons of this woman to go and make them slaves. But this woman said, no, I will not go to hang myself. I will not commit suicide. No, even if my husband has died and those creditors are knocking my door, I don't have anything I can pay them. I know I can call on God who knows how to answer. And she went to Elisha and she told him, you know, man of God, it is not I'm coming to Elisha, but I'm coming to the anointing that God has put in your life that I know it can change everything. The Spirit of God is what I'm coming to seek through you. Oh, man of God, look, my husband feared you, but he has died. And my only two sons, they are about to become slaves just because I cannot pay debt. God knows just what you need and how to solve it. That's why it's called solving God. He knows what you want and where it is, and he can cause any situation out of anything. Just the same way he sent a raven, go and feed my servants. Go and go, Elijah, go to a woman in Zarephath who is a widow. She has nothing, but as you go there, life, her life will change. I come to stand here and say, may your life change in Jesus' mighty name. May God use me as his servant this hour, this very hour. Let the anointing of God who fills empty jars flow into your lives in Jesus' mighty name. May God who fills empty jars, may he knock your doors. May he knock that bank account. May he knock that purse account. May he knock that family. Whichever you are lacking, may God who fills empty jars fill now those empty jars, and never again will you suffer shame. Never again will you suffer tears. Never again will you suffer humiliation in Jesus' mighty name. Ramakoza Taraboko Shekeyanta. So this woman, Elijah asked her, what do you have in your house? She said, I have nothing, I have nothing, I have nothing. And I can hear someone who's saying, I have nothing, woman of God, you don't know. I have been rejected and now I am 46. I've been rejected and now I have don't have a child, I'm 45. I'm about to hit menopause. It doesn't matter. God does not care how long you've been or how difficult it is. Elisha just told her, go back to your house, lock yourself with your son, go and borrow to your neighbors jars, and don't borrow a few, borrow as much as you can, because I'm about to do to you a miracle. I don't need to come and lay hands on you. I don't need to come and say I rebuke. There's a Spirit of God that can speak on any situation and give life to anything that is dead. And then she locked herself in that room with her son. She started emptying the little all that she had. I can imagine it was like, I don't know, less than, it was millimeter, not even a liter. And she began pouring. And because of her faith, obedience to the word of God will bring supernatural power of God. She just obeyed. She didn't ask, man of God, you didn't even come to my house. Man of God, you did not touch those jars. Man of God, you did not pray for that oil. But the Spirit of God, when he's speaking, there's a turnaround of every situation. She went into that house. She began pouring the little oil she had, and she began filling the empty jars. They began getting filled. They began getting filled until she told her son, "Give me another one." And the son said, "There is nothing left. God will only let you go when you are fully satisfied. When you're fully satisfied, when he has already restored you." And she ran and she said, "You know what, man of God, all the empty jars that I borrowed, they are completely full, full to capacity." He said, "It's okay. I only wanted to sort out your situation. Go and sell and pay your creditors, and the rest, live with them for the rest of your life. When God comes to restore you, he does not work halfway. It is until everything has been sorted out. Otherwise, that's how his name will be glorified. If it is healing, it will be permanent. There is no way God is going to heal you quarter way. No. It will be permanent. If he removes that pain, permanent. If it is healing, permanent. If it is a job restoration, a job that will never beg you to borrow again. If it is business, he's going to teach you new ways to operate in that business. He is a God of restoration, and when he restores, there is no way you're gonna go back again. You will not go back to the same situation again." He said, "Woman, go and sell that oil. Go and sell. Pay your creditors. It doesn't matter how many millions. But you're gonna pay all of it, and you're gonna live with the rest for the rest of your life. Permanent restoration." Makashatalaba. I am coming to speak to a child of God who is watching me. As you are connected to this anointing, as you are connected to Jehovah himself, as you are connected in the name of Jesus Christ, there is a complete rebuilding, complete reconstruction, complete restoration, fixing which that was hurting, fixing which that was giving you pain, fixing that which was making you to have tears, fixing that situation permanent in Jesus' name. I don't know who is watching me who has been having chest problem. It's a complete healing in Jesus' mighty name. All you need to do is believe. All you need to do to be a candidate of these words I'm speaking. If it's only one thing you need to do, believe. Believe. I don't know if that was been having pain on the west line, on the left side. I'm talking of west line. The person who had lower pain on the abdomen got healed long time ago. Na yo tukamaliza. Got healed long time ago. But there's someone with pain on the west line, on the left side. You are totally healed. Just touch the place. Touch the place. It doesn't matter whether you are in whichever continent, just touch that place. Even if it's someone in your family, you can touch on their behalf. Touch that place and say, "It is me, woman of God." Touch that place, west line on the left side. Touch that place and receive your healing. Receive your healing. And it doesn't matter whether it was kidney that was sick. It doesn't matter whatever it is a complete, total healing in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. I stretch my hands and say, to whoever shall believe, faith comes by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. If you've heard what I've said, and if you believe it, you are a candidate of this restoration in Jesus' mighty name. You are a candidate of this restoration in Jesus' mighty name. Never again will there be shame in your life. I come to stand as a servant of God. Never again will there be tears in your life. Never again will there be humiliation in your life. Never again will there be scarcity in your life. Never again will there be which that had caused you to have pain, caused you to have tears, made you to be mocked. There is a turnaround, and I come to stand of one of God. 1 Peter 5:10. After you have suffered and lived a while, whoever shall believe in this word, just believe in the word of God, not me. This word I'm speaking, I'm just opening my mouth to release it. After you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you permanent. There is a seal. This word that God has done
lightning, and I seal the world with the blood of Jesus. Nothing will plug it out from that situation. It is already working in the spiritual realm. It is about to, you're about to run like that woman and say, hey, you man of God, that time when you're preaching online, I overheard what you said. I heard what you said, and I was called for a new job interview. I went to my business and customers began flowing. I had pain. My husband had pain. My child had pain. But they got healed immediately after you have suffered for a little while. For a little while. For a little while. The God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Jesus Christ, will himself restore you, confirm, strengthen, and establish that situation permanently in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Right on, my God. I don't know who is watching me. I don't know who is watching me. Blood pressure, I arrest you and I command you in the name of Jesus Christ, leave. In the name of Jesus Christ, it doesn't matter whether you are connected. Someone else is sick in your family. I decree, not by my power, not by my strength, but by the Spirit of the living God, that sickness, whatever sickness you're suffering, may it live and live permanently in Jesus' mighty name. Whatever the Lord, every Lord that the enemy had put in your life, may it be cast away. In Jesus' mighty name, may God of all restoration, whoever had suffered, humiliation comes with lack of authority. Humiliation comes with lack of authority. And the enemy has put you a burden of tears in your life. May God of all grace restore you, confirm, strengthen, and establish you permanently. Never again. And I'm talking to someone, there's a mild pain here. I hear a new knocking door of new resources. I don't know whether it's a job or it's a business, but it's something new, empowerment. That's what I had. It's a confirmation in the spiritual realm, and I decree in the name of Jesus Christ, may it manifest on the physical ground. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord of all grace, our Lord and our Savior, the Sovereign God, Father, let these words be followed by signs and wonders in Jesus' mighty name. May these words be followed by power of God and anointing of God that shakes mountains to melt, that divided the sea, that makes the hills to heap like calves. That anointing, Father, that anointing, oh Lord Jesus Christ, Marco Shata Laboko Zekeyanta, in the name of Jesus Christ, Anthony, there is a new empowerment. Come back here and assure me. There is a new empowerment for you in Jesus' mighty name. And any person who shall believe these words, Meka Shoterebo, Father, not by my name, but by your name, Jesus Christ. You said whatever we ask, we believe it. I believe there is a restoration. Whoever is watching me, there was chest congestion or chest sickness, whatever it is, touch yourself and say, thank you, Jesus, because you are healed permanently. You are healed permanently in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Abba Father. Ride on my Father. Ride on my Jesus. Ride on my God. Ride on Holy Spirit and touch them. Touch them, touch that family, touch that business, touch that pain. There is a pain, someone watching me or someone in your family, pain on the left leg. Rima, because I want you to say it is me. Come on, children of God. I don't want to look like I'm lying here. There is pain on the left leg, not the feet, not the thigh, not the knee, but not the ankle, but just that leg, you know, that front part. Receive your healing in Jesus' mighty name. Receive your healing in Jesus' mighty name. Receive your healing in Jesus' mighty name. Abba, Father, I lift my hands. I lift my hands. Use them as a tool. Oh, Lord God of heaven. Oh, Lord God of all grace. Release financial increase. Release financial increase. Release financial increase to your children. No more tears in their lives. No more scarcity in their lives. No more mockery in their lives. No more pain and shame. Abba, Father, let these words be followed by signs and wonders. In your name, Lord Jesus Christ, by your spirit, let it be fulfilled in Jesus' mighty name. Someone, a lady, you're watching me, there has been an itching on your breast, left side. If that is you, don't be ashamed. God loves you. God likes you. There has been an itching, not a serious thing, but God wants to do something to you. I want you to say, it is me. It is me. It is me. Someone itching on the breast, the right breast. The right breast. Receive your healing. I hear establishment in family. Whether it was a fighting, or there was no peace, or it is a family that was something was had happened, there is a total restoration in that family in Jesus' mighty name. Someone watching me, I can't say you're deaf. No, you're not. But you're right here. You're right here. Or someone in your family can hear, it's a small boy. There is a problem on your right ear. And you also have like an allergy. You itch your ears, especially in the morning. Touch your ear like this. God of all grace, open that ear in Jesus' mighty name. It's done in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Abba, Father, as I stretch these hands to your children, God of heaven, God who said silver and gold belongs to you, Lord, may you restore your children. God, may you restore your children. God, may you restore your children. May they testify of your goodness in the land of the living. May they testify that you are sovereign God, who said silver and gold belongs to you, who created everything that is on in this world, anything that is visible. Father, it came to be by the mention of your word. As I speak the word that you've sent me tonight, let there be restoration in Jesus' mighty name. I hear financial increase. I hear financial overflow. I hear increase in wealth in Jesus' mighty name. And I come to lift these hands and I talk by and I say by the God of heaven, by God of all grace, let there be increase in your life, and never again will my people be ashamed again. That's the word I got. Never again will my people be ashamed again. Marco Sako Yantaraba. Franco, I don't know you, but I don't know where you're calling me from. But there is a pain that has been on your upper jaw. And I come to decree and declare. It's not about the pain I'm talking about, but I'm coming to tell you as a servant of God, never again will you cry again. Never again will you cry again. Never again will you cry again. By the power, by the spirit of the living God, Jehovah himself, who revealed to himself to Moses and said, people didn't know my name before, but now they're about to know me as Jehovah, because signs and wonders will accompany you. Now I come to speak about that name of God, Jehovah himself, Jehovah Jireh, who provides from nothing. He provides for Abraham from thicket. He found a life lamp. May you find life, something that shall say, Jehovah Jireh has visited me. Jehovah Jireh has visited my family. Jehovah Jireh has visited my business. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. I would like to read from the last scripture as I go. Listen to this. Let this, the word of God, be confirmed in your life. Psalms 126:1-2. Listen to the word of God. It is the word that will change you, not me. It is the word of God that will give you life. It is the word of God that will heal you. It is the word of God that is bringing that restoration. Psalms 126:1-2. When the Lord makashuta raboko zekeyenta. Listen to this, child of God. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion. When the Lord restored to those children of God that was watching me, and to those children of God that were waiting on him. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Wanzila. Ah, mention your name. When the Lord restored the fortunes of you. We were like those who dreamt. Our mouths were filled with laughter. Our tongues with songs of joy. And that it was said among the nations, among the peoples brought goodness, if I be a servant of God, I hear financial increase, a season of restoration, a season of peace, a season of restoration. Never again will you cry of the same problem again in Jesus' mighty name. Come number two, I come to say, may you and your household, God of turnaround, God of second chance, God who restores, God of the heaven and the earth, God who restores and God who created everything out of his mouth, God who created the sun, God who created the moon, the stars, and you and me, may he visit you and people witness and say, God of all grace has done great things for them. God of all grace has done great things for them. God of all grace has done things for them. They are getting new jobs. Their businesses are going to be revived. Their healths are getting life again. In the name of Jesus Christ, by the power that broke the grave, that rolled away the stone, and that resurrected Jesus Christ, that power is going to resurrect you that was dead in your life. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of Glory. God of all grace, touch your children and never again may they never cry again. I've seen a green light flash, pop, and a green light says, go. Let them, tell them to go. Tell them to move in Jesus' mighty name. Light, green light also says, celebrate. Celebrate because God has confirmed this, is going to do it in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. I love you so much. I love you so much. My name is Wanzela Wamanzia. Thank you so much, servant of Most High God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for joining me. God bless you richly. And never again will your life be the same again. Never again will your life be the same again. Christine Muthui, just do this. There's a baby in your family with pain on the left ear. Just do this. In Jesus' mighty name, let that pain go. In Jesus' mighty name, let that pain go. Touch this part also. In the name of Jesus Christ, any person watching me with pain on the eye, may that pain go in Jesus' mighty name. May that pain go in Jesus' mighty name. May that pain go in Jesus' mighty name. It is done, it is done, it is done. Financial increase in Jesus' mighty name as I go. That's the word. Financial increase in Jesus' mighty name. Barikiwa sana Wanzela. Bye. I love you so much.